If we have a look at these very simplistic diagrams of an optical splitter and a WDM module, it pretty much looks like they're doing the same thing. But that most definitely isn't the case. If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. To understand the difference between an optical splitter and an optical multiplexer, so WDM, let's first have a look at the optical splitters. So basically what an optical splitter does is it takes this optical signal and it will literally split the signal onto the different outputs, but completely passively. And because it's passive, what that means is, in this case we've got a 1/2 splitter, that the 100% optical input signal is then divided on 2 × 50% of the optical signal. Now, of course, we've also got different split ratios, and that then also divides it evenly on those, onto those outputs. So if we've got a 1/4 splitter, it means that each individual output will have 25% of the input signal power. We can go further than that. We've got a 1/32 splitter, meaning that each individual output will have 3.125% of that optical power of the input signal. But the important thing is that the signal from a content point of view, from a data rate and everything, they're completely identical on the outputs. They're all exactly the same signals. The only thing that is being split is the optical power. And that's why they are also very often referred to as optical power splitters. Now, if we go to WDM, the situation is a slightly different one because, number one, we will always have two sides of the link. In other words, we will always have an optical multiplexer and an optical demultiplexer. Now, the optical multiplexer takes different signals that are then on different wavelengths, and that will then combine these signals with filter technology, for example, and combine them onto a single fiber. And on the other side, the demultiplexer, once again with filter technologies as an example, will separate those signals onto the individual outputs again. But the important thing here is that each individual signal is completely independent from the other ones. We can even mix and match different data rates. So we can have here a 1 gig signal, a 10 gig, a 25 gig and a 100 gig signal. And the important thing is, on the other side, we'll still have 1 gig, 10 gig, 25 gig and a 100 gig because they are literally independent signals. But we will, of course, have some optical power loss, but that's due to the insertion loss of the multiplexers and the attenuation of the fiber cable. But this isn't a signal splitting, and that's why we're not losing or dividing the optical power. Now, from an application point of view, since the splitters are such a nice, very cost-effective signal distribution solution, they are a lot of times used in the passive optical networks, so the PON networks, very close to the end user. So we've got it more than in the fiber to the home application. Whereas WDM, because it's such a very cost-effective solution to maximize the capacity of individual fiber strands, they're then used to retrofit and maximize existing fiber links. So if you've got a big data center going to a smaller data center, you need more capacity than the existing fiber can deliver, you can deploy then WDM to add more signals to each individual fiber cable. Now, to summarize, so we've got from the splitter point, from a functionality point of view, the splitters are very cost-effective signal distribution solutions, whereas WDM is a very cost-effective fiber bandwidth expansion solution. The optical power with the splitter, hence the name optical power splitter, is split evenly between the different outputs. And with WDM, yes, we do have some power loss, but that is more due to the insertion loss and the fiber attenuation. From the data rate point of view, the splitters, they have exactly the same data rate, input and output exactly the same because they are literally the same signal, just the optical power is being split. Whereas WDM, they are completely different and independent channels, meaning that each individual channel can have a different data rate. And from an application point of view, well, the splitters are used more in the PON networks, close to the end user. And WDM, well, that is basically everywhere where you want to overcome the fiber capacity exhaust, where fiber is already deployed and deploying new fiber isn't really an option. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. Also, remember to follow our channel so you get your regular dose of brain snack. And Until then, bye-bye.